Pat Cox.
Good evening. Tonight, staff is coming to City Council to ask for them to declare the parcel shown on the attached maps on items A and C, that they be declared undevelopable, so that we can authorize staff to be preparing the necessary legal documents and authorize the sale of these primitive parcels to the adjacent property owners in accordance with state law. Do you want me to go over each one of them separately, or do you want me to go over both together?
I think we can lump A and C together, and we'll vote on both of those parcels.
Okay.
I see no reason not to.
Okay. All right. Parcel A is a parcel that's roughly 0.047 acres of land. It's to work with Dr. Eames on the second, on the south side of the Woodrow Wilson extension project. As part of that project, we had to locate the driveways into the existing developments off Patterson based on where the DOT allowed us to curb cut. Consequently, we ended up displacing four parking spaces. What this will do is, if you declare it as undeveloped parcel, then we can sell it directly back to Dr. Eames, and we can use that land to replace this displaced parking. That's what's going on in Parcel A. On Parcel C, similar situation. It's on the north side of the extension. It's adjacent to Plant and Griffith. And this is a little bit larger parcel. It's a 0.434 acre parcel. And again, we're displacing parking spots there. And what this, by declaring this undevelopable, what you're basically saying is that the parcel itself doesn't have a configuration that would allow it to be a good sale on the open market, because it's you can't fit, there's not a footprint in there where you can develop it. So it's really undeveloped. But it's good enough to be able to put in the four parking spaces that also Plant and Griffin is using. So anyway, so tonight again we're asking you to declare the parcels on these two maps on A and C as undeveloped and authorize us to proceed with preparing necessary legal documents and authorize the sale of the primitive parcel to the adjacent property owner in accordance with state law.
And then the sale price will be based on the per square foot basis, based on the purchase price.
That's correct. It's the fair market. We've got appraisals for both of them.
Any questions?
Just confirmation for the so Parcel A is the smallest of the three properties, 0.047.
Correct.
And the largest of the three properties is Parcel C at 0.435.
Correct. 0.434.
434? Okay. And you're not going to be acting on Parcel B?
Yeah, at this time, we're going to just retain that. There's no need to
okay.
No need to stop.
Thank you.
So, how many feet is in?
Okay, in the 0.434 acres of land, that's 18,898 square feet, and in the
0.2 I thought about 20 wood beds.
You don't know?
18,000 square feet.
Yeah.
You
can see it on the there's a map. Do you have the map?
We'll see the map.
Okay.
It's in your
package.
What was your question, son? I'm just wondering how many square
feet. Here, I've got a map.
I see it. Is there a time we can see it?
This is where the road comes through.
It's again, it's the 0.434 acre one, Larry, is 18,898, roughly 18,900 square feet.
Well, 90 by 90
would be 18,000 square feet. Other questions on that?
Happy with
yeah, that's, I understand that's okay.
That
Yes. We're still working out the deals with them, but yes, I mean, I've gotten attended, yes, I don't have an official sign.
I'm moving to that.
Okay, so I can't say that the deals are sealed.
Any other questions on these two? Again, we'll be voting on parcel A and parcel C. Parcel B is being withheld. All right. Could I entertain a motion then?
Mr. Mayor?
Mm-hmm.
Make a motion to approve the request as presented by Mr. Collins in regards to parcel A and parcel C on the Wood Road Wilson project.
Second.
Motion and second. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor signify by raising your right hand. All opposed, there are none. Motion carries.